hopefully this is at least a little bit better. Hi! I'm Scorpion! Scorpion's Fatality on YouTube, DeviantArt, Facebook. Well, it used to be Facebook until somebody reported. Cat! I'm gonna have to excuse that little shit.
Yeah!
Woo! And I do have an Instagram, which I still think that site is for children, but whatever. I'm going to be showing you how I put on my bodysuit and how, tips and tricks for putting on yours. This big monstrosity fluffy thing has a vinyl tail cover, but I don't feel like grabbing it because it takes about 20 minutes to put on. Now with my tails, my big long fluffy tails, this is about 7 feet. I don't know. I'm short. I'm 5'5". Now, this tail is single stitch. Everything you're going to see is made and sewn hand by me. I'm not going to get feet, paws. I'm not going to get the head. What you want whenever you're about to put on your tail, think of what way you're putting your tail on. Do you want it this way? Do you want it the other way? Are you right-handed? Are you left-handed? If I put my tail on, wonky. Just say wong. It's so majestic. And then just slide that through. Now, as you can see, this tail is pretty big. How is this belt going to support it? I don't know. Magic. That's how. Now, you don't want to put your tail on right now. Some bodysuits, I think Sky Pro, don't quote me on that. Also, I know she looks like freaking shit. But, you know what, I'm not getting brush out just for this one video. I'll do it after. Now I can hear everybody screaming. Now, with my suit, I'm too lazy to actually show close up. Fucking dog toys. My padding is not sewn in. It is removable padding, but I don't know if I want to do digigrade. I will possibly take plantigrade bodysuits because they are so comfortable. I actually have a silver and white one. Whenever you have a bodysuit that has the padding that's loose, this is not loose padding. This is actually in by bands holding it. Now, also another thing that I should mention is I don't have Under Armour. I don't have $100 to spend on a shirt and pants. Fuck that. What this lovely monstrosity is, sweatpants and a shirt that I got at a thrift store. And I had another one that I bought. I had to chop it up. And onto the bottom because this is like ridiculous. You want to be wearing socks whenever you go fursuiting, of course. Don't be that person who don't wear socks. But like I said, this is just to show. Now with my bodysuit, both my bodysuits, but specifically this one, since I didn't use duct tape dummy, I went off my own measurements, which I will not be doing for clients, no matter what. You cannot tell me what to do. Lord, it was a nightmare. Hence why some things on my suit, this bodysuit specifically, look really wonky. So, yeah. If you make your first bodysuit and you want to skimp out on a duct tape dummy, don't. Okay, now you might be like, alright, I got my Pete, I was gonna say my Pete, but this is the Pete. Take your tail. It has to be this time. Alright, there's gonna be a little hole. Oh my god, a mersuit hole! No, shut up. No. I just cut one in her because she didn't have one and I was doing repairs. Whew! Now, I know this tail does not match the bodysuit. have my tail as tight as possible. I was gonna make that joke, but now. Oh my god. If this belt breaks, I'm gonna laugh so hard. Oh my god, it did break. Whatever, okay. Nice belts are for the weak. Oh, the leather piece fell. I gotta have that tighter. Me, what I used to do for my belts is, instead of this lovely monstrosity, I actually used to do fleece belts that I would sew, and after, also, please excuse my hair, I just showered not long ago. I would actually do fleece belts on the top of the tail, and then I would just run around with a ribbon tied around my stomach. Now, we got the arms on. Whenever you're putting the arms on, and if it's a tight suit, go slow. With any suit that has arm wrist escapes, use them. Use them so much. With this, the fur, I have had to chop it off. That was by the zip. I should probably do that on my other bodysuit. Now, you see, I'm in suit now. This tail, I'm just gonna warn you, if you get long, draggy tails, assholes will try to pull on them. So, you're warned. A good thing is, you can see this is like a fucking broom, so you're gonna wanna make sure you have a cover on that. If you are commissioning somebody and you're not going to make your own because you don't know how to sew or whatever, well, one, you need to learn the basics of sewing, because if a piece on your fursuit, a seam pops, or something falls off, and you don't have anyone around you, and you need to get it back on, you need to learn a basic stitch. I will probably be posting a video on that. Also, I don't know how my video of me suiting up in this fluff ball got almost 300 views in like a week. Or whatever it was, I don't know. 2 weeks, 3 weeks, I don't know. But, like, holy crap, is it really that amazing? Well, true, there isn't really that many Dutch suit-ups. This suit, everything but the tail. The tail is for, another character. But I know the leg padding looks wonky, and, like, it looks massively ridiculous, but like I said, I did have a duct tape dummy. Also, I've seen some people just make it look like, from the front, it just looks like leg tumors because they did foam, and then it's just the back, like, they don't shape it to look like circles, so it looks so bad. Like, I can name a suitor right now who had that problem. I'm not being mean, don't go attack them, don't go harass them, but Cord Kitty, whoever made his fursuit did a terrible job on the leg padding because it was foam and you could tell, and it looked like tumors from the side. It looked off. It looked wonky as hell. If you're gonna make leg padding and you're gonna charge money for it, you have to know what you're doing. You can't just be like, oh, I'm gonna do this or I'm gonna do that. I really hope that this actually recording my face. It's gonna be shit lighting, but you know what? I don't care. Yeah. Also, with fursuit wings. Little wings. I actually had to resew these on at least 3 times. So the first time, his bodysuit was actually like skin tight, and then all these things. Yeah, I know the wings are wonky as shit, but another reason why they are far outwards so much, no duct tape dummy, and I can put a backpack on without having to worry about my wings getting smooshed. If you are going to make your own bodysuit, Do I recommend a sewn on tail or a tail with a belt loop? I recommend a tail with a belt loop, 100%. I never will recommend sewing it onto the bodysuit because if somebody rips your tail off, you're not gonna feel it. You're just gonna have this big hole. And then you'll be fucked. And then you will want to stab that person with a spoon. I don't know. But also, if somebody damages your fursuit at a convention, say you're at Anthrocon and somebody rips your tail, go to con staff. Complain. Actually, don't complain. Just tell them, hey, said person ripped my tail. Memorize badge names. That's important. Because if you know who has what badge name, then it'll make things much easier. So yeah. Anyway, for Tekoshikon, which is this weekend, I will not be going on Thursday because it doesn't start till 4, which is so stupid. I feel like Tekoshikon, when I went back in 2015, it was more organized. Actually, no, I can't even say that. Anthrocon is more organized, I mean. Also, when you sit down in the suit, you're gonna have big floofy pillows. I really need to brush this. Lord, this fur flying everywhere. It's not comfortable to sit in a fursuit, so if you're gonna sit on the floor, be prepared. Because it's not comfy. For anime cons, if you're going in fursuit, there won't be a headless lounge. There won't be well, actually there is water, but take your own. No matter what convention you're going to, always take your own water. I know, I look so stupid. I'm like sitting, I'm like, hello, and then the light is just making us even worse. Another big thing, if you're going to an anime con in fursuit, though, have a buddy or a handler, whatever. Don't go on your own, because if something happened to you in fursuit, it's not gonna be good. If you pass out in fursuit, and the medics come, they will actually cut your fursuit open. So, yeah, they're not gonna open your zip and take you out nice. If I actually passed out, I would definitely probably get this thing destroyed, and this thing was a fuck ton of work. I don't recommend getting skin tight bodysuits. I'm sorry, I know there are some people who are like, oh, I want to have a skin tight bodysuit. If you grow even a little bit, or if you gain a little bit of weight, or if you lose, well, actually, losing wouldn't do much. If you gain a little bit of weight, you're not fitting it anymore, and then it's like, oh, well, I just wasted all that money on this. There's another ramp. Damn it. Yeah. If you really, really, really want a skin tight bodysuit, make sure you get it not as fitting as you'd like. Get it at least a few inches bigger. This suit used to be skin tight. Now I kind of consider it skin tight still because it does cup me. Yay, no more rippy. This is all single stitch, which I need to double stitch it. There's so many seams. Ugh, hand sewing. I don't machine, so I am highly against machines. But whenever you go fursuiting out anywhere, if you go fursuiting to a park or something, I'm gonna sound so mean and so rude, but don't take your long tails and don't take your lovely, nice fursuit feet. I get it, some people might be like, oh, well, we can just wash them afterwards. The thing is, stains don't always wash out. So, and if you want to get a stain out of a fursuit, especially one like my Cremello tail, that's what this is. It's all single stitched. I know, it's amazing because single stitch. If you do commission me, I
100% will do a double stitch on any of my long floor draggy tails. I don't care if you pay for, if you want double stitch or not. It's just something that I like to guarantee my clients. Because if you have a long floor draggy tail, even if you only wear it like once every 5 months or whatever, I want you to be insured that you can put this thing on and you can hit somebody with it. Hopefully not a stranger. You can basically just go nuts with it and it's not going to rip easily. Now, yes, things pop, things break. But with my work, I like to make sure everything is sewn properly. For my fursuits, what I'm hoping to offer is a plantigrade, digigrade down the road, because right now it's just, eh. Digi is nice, but plantigrade. Partials, I will not be taking just parts. I will not be doing just heads either, unless I'm auctioning off a head by itself, which I do have pre-mades, and I was going to say I have a servo, but he's actually getting given away because reasons. I don't do free fursuits, no. Blueberry is going to a head trade, and Circle Boy, he's actually given to somebody for payment for hotel. But I will be at KoshiCon Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Like I said, I'm gonna be with a friend, and I probably won't be bringing this long tail. If you're gonna be at an anime convention, they don't keep their floors very clean, so beware. It's in the same place as Anthrocon. But regardless, they will not always keep their floors squeak clean. Anthrocon is really good about that because they know that, hey, there are people who pay a lot of money. I would say costs for all my suits, like what I put materials, but I don't think it's necessary. But, yeah. Possible fursuits that I'm going to be taking is this fluffy thing. Not this tail. I'll be having nub tails the whole con. Or my husky tail. Probably Artie the Wolf. Or Artie the Fox. Why is it wolf? I doubt I'm going to be wearing Duchess with this. Even though it's her suit, I just want to be able to breathe. Probably my wicker head with this. It's just meh. Okay, well, ghosties. And then maple hoof, my Dutch. So, I don't know. Anyway, sorry about the rambles. I'll walk around and see you for a minute. I have barely had any practice in this, so I'm just here like, oh yeah, I have a body suit. Also, if you do make measurements on your body, wear at least 20 pounds of clothing underneath. Bulk the shit out of yourself. Make yourself overheat while you're making this thing. Just wear so much clothes, because I would rather have it being bulky and baggy, which I did for my planty, than have it not fit in the slightest. Which is bodysuit I actually had to make mega repairs on. Oh, Jesus, raining. Again. Why am I even surprised in Pennsylvania? But just be aware that bodysuits are actually harder to make than people make it seem. people make it seem like, oh, you just make a duct tape dummy and then you do this and that. No, they are hard. Oh, I'm so sorry that this is wasting everybody's time. Spooky noises. So this bodysuit actually does fit me. It's pretty slim. Now, whenever you're getting out of a bodysuit with a tail that deattaches, why Pennsylvania? Why do we have to have shitty weather every day? I swear. Take your belt, undo it. Now grab the belt from behind and slowly slide. Because if you yank that thing out, you can actually rip your suit. Go slow whenever you're putting on a bodysuit. Don't be like, I gotta rush and put it on! Because if you do that, you're gonna rip half the fur out. As well as it's not going to be fun. Now, whenever you're done in a bodysuit, make sure you zip zip. Now, this thing is heavy as hell, so I can't exactly store it properly or whatever. So, you have to make sure you have something to hang it over, or else the padding is gonna stretch the legs out. And then you'll have padding up here, and then you'll have padding on your foot. Nobody wants that. No matter how strong seams are, I don't care who made it. I don't care if it's SkyPro, Autumn Fallings, Monster Cat, Cuddle Suits. I think that's her name. Whoever makes your suit, you have to know, ask them questions. If anyone wants to ask me questions on my suits, before they even think of commissioning me, do it. Because if you don't ask, you'll never know. And if a maker says, no, I'm sorry, I do not do X thing, don't ask them, hey, but I'll pay you extra. No, that's not how it works. For my bodysuits, I think I am going to just charge a little bit more muns for it to be double stitched, but I might just automatically make it set price instead of even offering single, because single stitch, unless it's plantigrade, these things are heavy. The padding is heavy. Also, will I do chest floof, like how some suits have a padding that you can slide in and it'll just make the chest look bigger? Not boobs. I don't do that. Don't ask me. Butt padding, I will consider for, like, horses or something, because whatever. But, if you ask me to do boobs, I'm gonna say no. Don't ask. Also, whenever you travel with a fursuit, please be aware. It'll get dirty. Get a duffel bag or something. Anyway, thank you very, very much for watching. Thank you all for almost 300 subscribers. I got like three new subscribers. What am I saying? Five people wouldn't join. But anyway, thank you very, very, very much for watching my content. And just thank you all for the nice comments. Oh, I can't remember your name. But there's a specific YouTube littlest pet shop person who keeps commenting all my stuff, and like, thank you very much, thank you, oh, you're so kind, I'm gonna have to do a video for you. Anyway, since today is disgusting out, I might be doing a few videos on sewing techniques, or what to do if you got a seam rip, and just whatever. Don't hot glue fursuits. If you're not the maker of a fursuit and seam pops, even if you are the maker, you shouldn't do it. Don't grab a hot glue gun from somebody and just glue the shit out of it. Because if you do that, and then after the con's over and you try to send it to the maker's going to charge you a fortune. Because they're going to have to replace all that fur in that little patch. And then you're going to be like, oh, well, I fixed it, didn't I? And they're going to be like, no. Anyway, thank you very, very much for watching, and I hope that somebody at least stayed to the end. Bye!